They torture each other with red hot horseshoes. And worst of all, they keep their females in common.
The other farmers were frightened by the rebellion of the animal farm and anxious to stop their own animals from hearing too much about it. But rumors of a wonderful farm where animals managed without human beings continued to circulate. The pigs fought back. They sent out flights of pigeons to mingle with the other animals on neighboring farms, talk to them about the rebellion, and teach them the tune of beasts of England.
How can the animals bring themselves to sing such contemptible rubbish? They needed a good flogging.
And yet, the song was irrepressible. The blackbirds whistled in the hedges, the pigeons cooed in the elms. It got in the van of the cities and the tune of the church bells. The human beings listened and secretly trembled, for in the song they heard a prophecy of their future. Early in October, the animals met our next great test.
Man is fleeing from the countryside, and soon
Yes.
I'm sorry I couldn't stay. I had to hide my head in the hay. I can't stand the explosion.
Comrades, what shall we call this glorious day? Every October the 12th, every anniversary, we must have a celebration. And what shall this battle be called?
There is but one name for it. Snowball's Battle.
No!
I think you will agree that is the wrong name. You all bought this battle. You all bought this victory. Let it be named the Battle of the Cowshed. That was, after all, the place where the ambush was from.
Yeah.
Agreed?
Was stroking her nose and beating her sugar.
barley.
Yeah!
Yes. Our farm is looking to a bigger acreage with oats.
Yeah! Yes.
The goat's meadow is just right for cabbages.
Yes!
The meadow is useless for anything except roots.
Yes! Yes!
Comrades! Comrades!
Snowball often went over the majority with his brilliant speeches.
Yesterday had the smell of blood. Slavery was a name. Today is when he becomes the world. And I know that you feel the strain. But tomorrow is your children's day. And we labor for things they gain. The potatoes and apples.
Here is a map of the farm. Every animal is giving a starting point. He moves 3 steps a day. If each animal drops their dung directly in the field and at a different spot each day, the saving in labor of carting will be...
May I interrupt? I have no schemes. I believe in quiet, conscientious work, not risks.
Napoleon was better at camps than to himself between the leaves. He was especially successful with the sheep, who are always ready to interrupt when Snowball's scheme sounded confusing.
Snowball's scheme may be very ingenious, but it won't work.
Yes, it will work.
4 legs good, 4 legs good, 2 legs bad, 2 legs bad.
The sheep must allow us to talk. We must say what we think.
Of course, Boxer.
Snowball and Napoleon had many controversies, but the most bitter was the one over the windmill. The windmill designed by Snowball.